Hello, Hashima. This video is for Tuesday, April 14th, Fraction Word Problems, Lesson 111. We're almost done with all of our review here. Today, we're going to be just solving word problems involving fractions. So just some reminders of some strategies that you can use for solving word problems. The first one is chunk the problem. What we mean by that is list out the facts. So if there are three numbers in the problem, you should have three bullet points and list out each fact. Second thing, visualize. It always helps to draw a picture, a simple bar diagram, something labeled, a table, something to help you visualize what's going on in the problem. And then finally, retell. You can do this by taking out the numbers. And instead of getting hung up on what each fraction is, just think about what the problem is actually saying, and almost like a story, what's happening first, next, last. All right, just a quick concept review to remind you of how to work with fractions. This should be pretty much review for you. But looking at addition and subtraction of fractions, notice both of these are written vertically up and down. So in addition and subtraction with fractions, you're going to need to make sure that you find a common denominator. So in the first one, 3/8 plus 2/5, the common denominator is 40. Make sure that you are showing how you get to your new numbers. So instead of 3/8, we're going to multiply by 5 to get 15/40. Instead of 2/5, we're going to multiply by 8 to get to 16/40, so that when we add, we get 31/40. The next one is 7/8 minus 1/2. So actually, 7/8 can just stay the same because a common denominator between 2 and 8 can be 8. So the only thing you have to change is 1/2 and turn that into 4/8, so that 7/8 minus 4/8 is 3/8. Multiplication with fractions is super simple, but notice it's written horizontally rather than vertically, because in this you don't have to worry about common denominators. All you have to do is multiply straight across. So 5 times 1 is 5, 6 times 3 is 18, so 5/6 times 1/3 is 5/18. Notice division, the last one here, is also horizontal. It is not vertical. Remember, you need to leave, change, flip. So you're going to leave the first factor, so 1/2 stays the same. Change division into multiplication, which we did right here, and then you're going to flip the second factor. So instead of 5, it's going to be 1/5. That's the reciprocal. So then multiply straight across. 1 times 1 is 1. 2 times 5 is 10. So the answer is 1/10. You start with a fraction, end with a fraction. So that's your concept review. Then we're going to look at some word problems. The only tricky thing here is choosing what operation to do. So let me show you example A, which says that a recipe for a batch of spaghetti sauce includes 3/4 a cup of tomatoes. Drew made 2 1/2 batches of sauce, and we want to know how many cups of tomatoes he used. So notice I circled three numbers. So I have two bullets here, and I just put in one batch, the third number with the first bullet. So 3/4 of a cup of tomato sauce makes one batch, and we want to know how many cups we need for two batches. So I drew a picture here of 2 1/2 batches. Notice I only shaded in two and a half of these. Each full batch has 3/4 of a cup. So that means that I'm going to need to multiply because there's equal groups here. So 2 1/2 times 3/4. Remember to turn 2 1/2 into an improper fraction, so it becomes 5/2. Then you can multiply straight across and you should get 15/8. Once you've got 15/8, turn it back into a mixed number. 8 goes into 15 one full time with 7 left over. So 1 7/8. Example B. We've got Paveen collecting 24 9/10 kilograms of cans for recycling. Exactly 2/3 of those cans were red. We want to know the total amount in kilograms of red cans that Paveen collected. So again, two numbers, I bulleted out two bullets, and I listed them out. When I did that, I said to myself, okay, I know the total is 24 9/10, and I know that if I split 24 9/10 into three equal groups, two of those groups is going to make up 2/3. So 2/3 of 24 9/10. This is a multiplication problem. It's scaling down 24 9/10 to only 2/3 of its size. So I wrote it out as multiplication. 24 9/10 times 2/3. I then converted 24 9/10 into an improper fraction to 249/10, which is pretty large, but that's what it has to be because we have 24 wholes. And then you're going to do that times 2/3. So multiply straight across. 249 times 2 is 498. And then 10 times 3 is 30. So 498/30. I actually did the division here so that I could work it out. And I got that 498 divided by 30 is 16, remainder 18. So with my remainder, I turn that into the numerator. Remember, the denominator stays the same. It's 30. So 16 and 18 thirtieths. And if you need to see some of my calculations, just take a look here. And then to reduce that down to simplest form, I divided both the numerator and denominator by 6. So when I did that, I got 16 and 3 fifths. So that's your final answer for this problem, which again was multiplication with scaling. So today you're going to solve all different kinds of word problems with all different operations. So you're going to make sure you draw a picture, list out the facts, and use your strategies. We will see you later.